Hey guys, it's me again, back for another video. For today's video, I really wanted to make a puffer tote. I've been seeing these puffer totes pop up all over TikTok, all over Instagram, and I've been completely obsessed with them. And I haven't seen anyone make a crochet version yet. So that's what we're gonna attempt to do for this video. I don't know how this is gonna come out. I don't even know if it's gonna come out. I don't know if it's gonna be good. I don't know if it's gonna be ugly. But you know what's the beauty in that? We're gonna figure it out together. Before we get started, I really wanna thank you guys so much for watching my videos. This channel has grown tremendously in the last few months, and I'm extremely grateful for it all. And if this is your first time seeing my face, go ahead and subscribe to this channel and turn your notification bell on so that you can be notified every time I post. I really want to keep this intro as short as possible because my YouTube analytics is telling me that my intros are a bit too long. So let's just jump right into the video. I'll be using this color for my tote bag because I'm obsessed with gray. This is the color Graybeard from the brand I Love This Yarn from Hobby Lobby. Y'all know this is my favorite brand of yarn, so this is what we'll be using. I have no idea what hook size I'm gonna be using yet, and I think I wanna use single crochets. I might change my mind later on because honestly, single crochet is my least favorite stitch. However, I think that's the stitch I'll be using today. So let's just go to the drawing board and start measuring and drawing this bag out so I can figure out how exactly I want it to look. So here is my little bootleg plan, and I know it makes no sense like this, so I'll explain it. Here is my little fake drawing of what I want the bag to look like. I want it to be 3x2, and I want it to be 15 inches by 10 inches by about 5 inches on the sides and 5 inches on the bottom. For this, I want my squares to be double-sided so that I can stuff polyfill in between each square to make it puffy. So I'm gonna need 12 squares that are 5 inches by 5 inches for the front, and also another 12 for the back. On the sides, I want them to just look like this, just 2 squares on top of each other. So I'm gonna need 4 squares on the side, on each side. So that's 8 squares altogether. And then on the bottom, I'm gonna do 3 squares double-sided, that'll be 6. Each square has 20 stitches with 22 rows of single crochet, and altogether we will need 38 squares for this bag. And then the straps, which I don't know what I want to do for the straps yet. I just drew up some straps here, but I'm not entirely sure which direction I want to take the straps. We'll figure that out when we get to the straps, but yeah, this is my plan. So here is the plan for this bag using my crochet project planner. The project planner is in my Etsy shop and on my website, but it is such a great way to plan out your projects. I swear I live by this planner. Before, I was just printing out the pages and writing on them, but now I can use them with my iPad. So if you have an iPad, I would strongly suggest getting a crochet project planner because this is everything. So here's the first page where I just plan out everything: the name, the yarn, the hook size, notes, description, everything like that, even the difficulty. On the next page is where I draw out my idea. So this is what I wanted the bag to look like. We got the 5x5 inch squares, 38 squares, double stuff them. Here's the strap. I didn't do the long strap because, you know guys, I ran out of yarn. So I'll come back and do the long strap another day. But here is the drawn out plan. And then I have the pattern planner, which is where usually I would have more notes. But since this pattern is literally just single crochet squares, there wasn't much to write. But this is essential for when I'm writing a long pattern so that I can write my notes along the way. And when it's time to type up the pattern, I can just refer to this and all my notes will be here. Then here is the brain dump, the idea and inspo page. This is where I write down all of my ideas so that they're just not stuck in my head. I actually have somewhere to go to check on the ideas that I had for that month. We have a crochet pattern cheat sheet, has your stitch abbreviations, your directional abbreviations, additional abbreviations, and your symbols and repeats. This is perfect for if you're new to pattern writing or pattern reading. This helps a lot. And then we have our yarn weight and hook
slash needle size for knitting and also for crocheting, because this journal is not only used for crochet, it's also used for knitting. You can decide whether you're going to be knitting or crocheting on the first page. But yeah, this is all that's available in the pattern planner. And once again, if you're interested in it, it's located on my Etsy and in my website. It is now day two of working on the puff tote bag, and here are all the squares that I finished on day one. I finished about 15 to 16 squares, and yeah, that's it. So we just got a few more squares to go. We have about about 22 squares left to go, so I'm just gonna get those done day three of working on this bag. I'm still making squares. I'm gonna be taking it really easy today because I had an eventful weekend, and honestly I'm exhausted, so I'm just gonna be laying down and trying to finish these squares today. Yesterday I only got about 2 squares done, which is not good, so hopefully today I can get another large chunk of these squares done, because I'm not trying to be making squares all week. That's not what I have planned for myself. So let's see how many squares I can get done today, and hopefully by tomorrow we'll be putting this thing together. I don't know what day we're on anymore, but it's a couple days later, I guess, like maybe like 1 or 2 days later, and I finally finished all these squares. I'll show you how many squares. I can't even hold all of them in my hand without them falling, but we finally finished all 38 squares, and now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna double them. So I'm gonna sew them together like this, but I'm only gonna sew 3 sides together, then I'm gonna stuff it with polyfill, and then I'm gonna sew that 4th side. So we're going to double up every square, sew them together, and fill them with polyfill. Let's see how long that takes, and then after that, we're gonna sew it all together. I'm actually running out of yarn. I have this much yarn left, and I doubt that this is gonna be enough to sew every square together and make the straps. So I'm probably gonna have to go to the store tomorrow and get some more yarn, which sucks, but it is life. I thought this bag was gonna be done in like 3 days tops, and now it's almost a week later. So I'm just gonna get started sewing these squares together.
Thank you.
please excuse my hair. It is getting washed today. I promise. But I finished all of the puffy squares. They look like little tiny pillows. So I really think that's adorable. And yeah, we finished all the puffy squares, sewed them all together, stuffed them all with polyfill. And now, well, not now because I'm gonna go wash my hair first. But after I wash my hair, I am going to put all of them together and then start constructing this purse. I have this much yarn left, so I'm hoping that that's enough to sew the purse together and also make the straps. So pray for me because we're playing yarn chicken, and just keep me in your prayers, and I hope that I don't have to go back to the store just to finish this bag. Brief commercial before I go wash my hair. I ordered an iPad a month ago and it just came. So I'm gonna open that baby up and play with it for a little while before I wash my hair. And yeah, so here's that. It's me again, on another day. Of course, this is not the same day as the last clip, because who would I be if I actually finished that bag when I said I wanted to, right? So here is the bag so far. Here it is in all of its glory. Here's the side, the bottom. Here it is. And I've only done one strap so far, so I'm gonna attach the strap like so. And I'm currently working on the second strap, and then we're gonna attach the straps to the bag, and then bag should be finished. I really did wanna make a long strap, but I don't think I'm gonna have enough yarn to, so I'm just gonna have to bite the bullet on that one or make the long strap another day, because I'm not going to the yarn store today. So yeah, we're just gonna make the straps, sew them onto the bag, and the bag will be done. Excel on the track. Also, the straps, I'm doing the straps with half double crochet because that is worked faster than single crochet, and I honestly don't have much left in my mental capacity to do single crochet straps. So we're doing half double crochets instead. So I did 10 half double crochet stitches and 44 rows for the straps.
Are y'all ready to see the final product? Because I don't think y'all are ready for how cute it came out.
And here we have it, the finished puff tote. It's so cute. I am going to put an outfit together and take some pictures with it.
So yeah, here is the finished bag, finally, after all this time. So I just finished taking pictures of the bag that I created.
I just realized as I was editing that I completely forgot to do an outro. So I want to thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys make this tote bag. If you do make the tote bag and you take pictures of it and you post it on socials, please tag me so that I can see it. If you're interested in the written pattern for this bag, it'll be in the description below. Don't forget to like and subscribe and turn your notification bell on so that you see every time I post. I love you guys and thank you so much for watching. Peace.